Hi everyone and welcome back. In this video we are going to talk about avoiding side effects. So this is really a common problem, and most of the developers do this mistake that whenever they try to change something, they always mutate the existing object, existing array or existing variable, when there is always a way not to mutate the current property or current object. Always create a copy of it, do the alteration and return the new object, array or property, something like that. So this is what most of the time we end up writing. And what we are seeing here in this, there is a name is a property, and while calling this method we end up changing the name property because we are assigning it back. So what can be the small fix in this problem is, instead of assigning it back, we can actually simply return it. So name will still be there and we can assign it to a new name which we are getting, and this is the name property we have. Okay, so there are many ways of dealing with these kind of problems. Sometimes what happens is you are writing a function, okay, let's say copy array or something, okay, and you are actually getting an object and you want to append some property, right? So what you should always do is you should always create a spread copy of this, which is obj, and if you wanted to add a new property, this can be done simply like this. So what this method is doing is, it's not updating this object directly, we actually created a copy and then we are appending a new property to this object. So side effects are nothing but like, you, whatever the object or whatever the reference you are passing, you should not alter it. You should always create a copy and then update it. So like this we always do while writing reducers in Redux. I'm talking about just some library. If you are not aware, that is fine. So like simply add item to cart. This is the function I'm writing and I'm taking two arguments. So there is a cart object. And I also have the item, right? What I can do simply is, okay, let's do a cart dot push, and I am doing a push with this item, and date is I will just say date dot now. Okay, I added just, I'm returning this. So what I'm doing is I'm actually updating the same reference which I got. Instead of doing this, what is the other alternative? You should always, because array, cart is an array, right? Array concatenation can be done through the spread operator. This is existing cart and I want to add something new in this, which is new item I have. Okay, and I have date property, which can be simply like date.now. And this is fixing our problem. I mean, there is nothing wrong in the earlier code also. It was just like we were mutating the same reference. Here we are actually returning a new cart object, cart array, having this new item added to it, right? So cloning big objects can be very expensive in terms of performance. So we already have the libraries like immutable.js, and you can actually do some custom coding to avoid those kind of situation. Okay, so this is how you can actually avoid side effects, and there are many advantages. First of all, you need to understand how we are making side effect and what all methods which are available in JavaScript which will help us. So always you can use this spread operator. So if we just talk about it, what all possible ways is there, right? If we are getting an object, you can actually do simply if consider this cart is an object and item is just another property, then I can just simply do, this is the cart, it's my object, and item is just another property. So it will take care of adding this property to it, and here we are avoiding these kind of side effects by updating the cart object directly. Now what are the other methods which are available which do the same thing? Like if you can think about array.prototype dot slice. So whenever you do array.prototype.slice 0 on any array, it will always create a copy of this. I'm just putting this code in the same function just to make you more clear. So this will create a copy of this without even without altering this. Even simply you can actually do a map, filter, all these things. It is going to create a new copy of this. So you can actually, whenever you are having const new array, now you can actually do whatever you want to do with the new array, as this array you are getting from the arguments. You can just get this in the argument itself. Array.map, new array. Now you do a new array.push or something and return that. Okay. Like if I just wanted to do a push, some new item to this 9 or something. Okay. So we can use array.map, array.filter, array.object.assign, spread operator, array.slice, whatever you see which is immutable method. Immutable methods, whenever you do slice on an array, it will not change the existing array. Whenever you do array.concat, it will not change the existing array. It will actually give you the new array with the concatted output. Similarly, array.map, array.filter, these does not change anything in the existing array. They are actually higher order function, returns you the new array, and those things you can actually use in your code. And when we talk about this React and Angular framework, this is always advised that you should not change the existing reference. Whenever you actually change, create a new reference, then only change detection triggers and you should be able to see the output. Okay, that's all about change detection.